Hello there. I have an interesting knife to show you. This is a compound with a modified handle shape, an interesting construction, and an inlay that has the shape of the River Mississippi near New Orleans. I will first show you what the knife looks like when it is assembled, but after that I have some clips for you of the inside of the knife or the components on their own, and then I can show you some interesting details that you would not see otherwise. Here it is, the Mississippi compound. The handles are made of Elforine Super Tusk, which is an ivory substitute, and each handle has an inlay of blue micarta. You can maybe see the pattern or the grain in this Elforine Super Tusk, and it indeed has the grain that normal ivory has. The inlays here, they have the shape of the Mississippi River, where it curves around the city New Orleans. New Orleans is somewhere over here and over here. This knife was made for someone that lives there, lives in New Orleans, and I thought it was a really cool idea to make this knife more personal. The knife design is my usual compound, but I have made, because the customer asked for it, change to this curve here. Normally it's a curve that fits one finger, but here it's bigger, it fits two fingers, and that enables you to flick the knife open like this. Here you can see the M390 hand-wrapped blade. And something else that makes this knife special is that it is a liner lock with hidden liners. So you can see they are there on the inside, but they only come to the outside of the handle over here, where you need it to unlock the knife. Now let's take a look at the inside of this knife. Nu heb ik hem gevonden. Here we have the four main handle components of this knife. Two titanium liners and two plastic handle scales. As you can see, this is the Loctite liner, which is made from titanium that has been sandblasted and tumbled. Here we have the lock bar relief and the ceramic Deaton ball over here. Come on, focus. Now, these handle scales here, you've already seen what they look like from the outside, but on the inside they look like this. Each of these handles has a pocket milled on the inside where the correct titanium liner fits into, and the pocket in this handle is a little bit less deep than the titanium liner is thick, so the titanium liner will stick out 0.05 millimeters. You can also see that I have left some clearance here for the stop-in, for the head of the backspacer screw. And that was the non-locking side. Here we have the locking side handle, which is pretty much the same, but it has an extra cutout here for the lock, so the liner lock can be disengaged.
I have quickly inserted the Loctite liner into its handle and assembled the backspacer a little bit to show you two things. The first is that the liner fits snugly inside the pocket in the handle scale, except for here at this point. And that is done intentionally because I needed some clearance so you can disengage and let the lock engage without it touching or scraping on the inside of the handle. Then also you can see here the backspacer. It is held in place by one 3mm pin and one M3 bolt or screw. And between these two I have another hole, and that is a hole that is used to surface grind to hold the backspacer on the surface grinder when grinding it to the correct thickness. What I want to show you by putting the handle together one step further is that the main structure of this knife's handle, so the parts that give it stability and strength, are actually the titanium liners and the backspacer, and not really the Elforin scales. As you can see, the hole for the pivot stopping and then the backspacer, those are all connected or all attached to the titanium liners. And then when the knife is assembled and you are cutting with it, your hand holds onto the Elforin handle scales, but you won't feel any movement between the titanium, the main titanium structure of the handle and the handle scales here, because the titanium liners fit tight into the Elforin handles, and also they are attached, or they are held in place by the friction of the screws here.
That's it for today. Thanks for watching and see you next time.